Hello, malty Middleton pot still malt mates. I'm Ralfy. Welcome to Ralfy Review 718. And thank you to Patrick. Yeah, for real. Patrick, you couldn't make it up, for supplying the malt mention. Thank you, Patrick. And you did ask me to hold this malt mention back for the next Irish whiskey review. Here in the Manx Bothy in the Irish Sea, right next door to Ireland, yes, to commemorate St. Patrick's Day. So no problem, Patrick. as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, malt mates and Irish whiskey fans, I'm really bringing my St. Patrick's Day celebrations right up to date and making them poignant, contemporary and relevant by not showering the environment with green tat and tacky disposable consumerist merchandise. We have the little fella up there and that's it, and I'm wearing a green hat, but a tasteful tweedy green hat as well. I may as well tell the world needs to know that Irish people are sick of the cheapening of St. Patrick's Day. It's a traditional festival celebrating the patron saint, and unfortunately, particularly in the US, it's been heavily commercialised and rendered into a parody of what it should be. I shall redress this situation in my own little inimitable way, maltmates, by conducting a whisky review of an Irish whisky called Glendalough 13-year-old Mizunara cask matured Irish whisky from the Wicklow Mountains in the east coast of Ireland. A very beautiful part of Ireland, but there again, there's many beautiful parts of Ireland. Now, this distillery has not been going very long. It's only been going a few years, so it couldn't possibly be bottling a 13-year-old version of its own whisky. And in fact, what it's done, as so many Irish distillers are doing, is that they have bought up stocks of Cooley whisky, which they are packaging under their own label as their own brand. Now, this does cause some confusion, so if you're into Irish whiskey, it's good to be aware of this, because the chances are your points of reference in terms of smell and taste of a brand of Irish whiskey may well suddenly change as that distillery starts to put out its own in-house made whisky matured at its own distillery. But how about this? What you need to know, bottled at 46%, until filtered, in my opinion, pretty natural colour, it's all good. And importantly, very importantly, it's not Redbreast. Everybody out there is looking for a version of Redbreast, because Redbreast is arguably one of the best Irish whiskies at an affordable price around at the moment. That's all very well, but there's other versions, and I think this is well worth your consideration. Interesting, on the label and the box, it says that the whiskey's been matured in American oak casks for 13 years and then finished in the Japanese Mizunara casks, but it doesn't specify for how long. Let me tell you, because of my experience knows, it's not been long at all. It's been a few months, if that. These are fresh Japanese oak casks that this distillery have imported. They're expensive casks, but the distillery have taken the risk that the attention that these casks get, the reputation that Japanese oak casks have, is going to be such that it's going to be good for their brand. And they're right. The nose has this exquisite, soft, almost confectionery resinous note to it, which is, it's not so much the coulee. The coulee, this whiskey, is playing host to this fresh Japanese oak wood, which I have never in my life found more expressive than in this particular glass. I have never encountered any Japanese whiskey which presented the Mizunara characteristics as well as this Irish whiskey is doing right here, right now. It's very different, and it really suits the Irish theme incredibly well. Barley sugar, soft, mild, minty notes. A little bit of resinous, beautiful, soft, sweet resinous, aromatic, spicy, some apricot, definitely. A little bit of peach in the background, a little bit of allspice there, some sweetest confectionery ginger notes, and we haven't even tasted it yet. This is a genuinely exciting whiskey, contemporary whiskey, very contemporary. Taste. Initially, resinous, sharp, astringent, syrupy, barley sugar. A little bit of corn syrup about it, interestingly. But I will now add a full teaspoonful of water. And what this is going to do is it's going to soften up this whiskey and amplify the characteristic, the personality that's coming out the glass, particularly when you taste it. Adding that water just softens the whole palate. And at the moment, neat, the palate is sort of uptight in the arrival. It's a little bit over concentrated in the arrival. And by adding the water, we just spread out that arrival to a little bit longer, and it becomes more definitive. The nose doesn't really change that much. There's more of a sort of wood, slight wood spice, sandalwood, cedarwood thing going on from the Mizunara cask. And it's when you arrive back in the palate, certainly before I go to the palate, the nose, it becomes a little more perfumed, a little more eau de cologne. Ah, the arrival is sublime now. It happens so fast. The water works so quickly. The arrival and the development are practically seamless. Soft ginger, barley sugar, pineapple, jam, definitely. The apricot still there. Those beautiful, exotic Japanese oak aromatic notes. I have never encountered them more expressive than in this glass. It really has been a very brief but successful contact between the coulee whiskey and these expensive, and if I might add, rather fragile casks. A beautiful thing to behold is a Japanese oak cask made from Japanese oak. Technical name is Mongolica. But the wood is a little bit spongy and soft. These casks need to be handled with care, and they are prone over time to leaking. So, distillers, if you're getting any of these Japanese oak casks, be aware of that situation. To conclude, before I give an Irish whiskey mark, to celebrate St. Patrick's Day, finish. I'll focus on the finish. Green notes, a little bit of gooseberry. The development, ginger, very expressive vanilla in the development. The finish, fresh fruit, pineapple, green banana, bit of kiwi fruit, and that lovely, warm, delicious, soft confectionery spiciness. Right, it's going to be a good mark. It is actually, yeah. 89 out of 100.
And that...
is a whiskey mark. An Irish whiskey mark. For this Irish whiskey review commemorating, celebrating, engaging with an internationally awareing... internationally exposing for awareness... St. Patrick's Day and Irish, what Irish whiskey can offer. I think when you try and make a cardboard box like look like wood, it doesn't work. But just to introduce this character here, you might think that's St. Patrick. It's not St. Kevin. There's quite a number of Irish, traditional Irish saints like St. Columbine and St. Kentigern. And they very much come from an ancient and very misunderstood tradition which has strong connections with the Essen philosophy and the Gnostic philosophy. And I want you to understand that I'm not going to go any further because someone will start troll commenting. I'm trying to be objective, positive, proactive and educational here. But history is shrouded in mist. And it is the mist of ignorance. Monkmates, if you want to know about Ireland and understand why Ireland is the country it is and is such an outward and international looking country now that is, in my opinion, got a very bright future in the global shakedown, is because Ireland has never gone out to make war on anybody, ever. And it's part of this long traditional culture that goes back before history was effectively censored by academics and the establishment. I'm going to leave it at that. Thank you for watching. I'm Ralphie. This has been an Irish whiskey review. I hope you enjoy your Irish whiskey on St. Patrick's Day and every other day in the year. Enjoy it sensibly, enjoy it modestly, and keep it, for goodness sake, keep it quality. I'm Ralphie, wishing you well. Goodbye.